What's up, guys? This is The Rifleman, and I am back bringing you to the next episode of my Empire Total War Let's Play as the United States. And as you can see, what's happened, carrying on from the last part, the Prussians have wandered too close to my fort, and I'm going to beg them to attack. And they do have some howitzers and such, but I also have some heavy horse artillery, which would be long range, to do some counter-battery fire. But more importantly, it means it's a Prussian army I'll be able to chew up as they try to storm my fortress. So without further ado, let's get cracking. I'd also like to try and side of the fortress. I mean, like if there are some trees outside, then I can dip not, then they may have to stay inside and sally out again. Ultimately, the howitzers may end up deciding to focus fire on the breaches onto the walls themselves, rather than actually trying to destroy troops within.
The enemy will try to smash their way in with siege equipment.
So they're deploying.
Use your heaviest troops to defend any.
They're deploying over here. Oh wow. So they're deploying straight ahead to the east and to the south. So let's take all of my guys. Oh well, I'm definitely going to be utilising my cavalry outside, because I have quite a lot of it. So let's put two cavalry units here. Just so I can shelter them a bit from any immediate artillery fire. Group. Okie dokie, so let's gamble and say they're going to be over here. And then, oh, wow, that's a, well, I forget how much these heavy horse artillery units get. These houses may be at risk. So why don't I put one here, one central, and then one facing this direction. Artillery battery just sit in reserve, wait for a breach, and then let's deploy up the infantry. Because deploying them here never really does anything. Like, at least here they can take up positions and fire down onto the gate or onto the into this breach. And I've never found defending here to be much use either, but it's tempting to give it a go for once. I can't actually deploy them there anyway yet. Let's try it actually. So let's put these two units here to go garrison this section of the wall. And then one unit of sharpshooters left. Let's put them here. Okay, so this infantry is actually going to come. So you're going to do this. You're going to unlimber. You're going to unlimber. You focus fire. 24 pounder. Oof, they are firing quick climb, probably into my cavalry. Can I fire quick climb onto the can. Good. Heavy horse artillery has destroyed that artillery battery, and that's exactly what I wanted to see. Okay, now critically. Start relocating. Force cavalry, which means the army is going to come over from that direction too. So let's preemptively make one of my howitzer batteries move over here. Straight shot to their artillery and to their general. So I have my artillery focus fire onto these moving troops. Ooh, some lag. The general's bodyguard. Good, lots of troops falling back. Well, they're well out of that artillery range. So whereabouts are they shooting? Okay, so need to get ready to prepare defensive positions around here. Let's put a unit of sharpshooters in this wall. Fire will off. Okay, let's send this weakened unit of lancers to go start hunting stragglers. Okay, get these guys to try garrison a set of guns after they run the wrong way completely. There we go. Come on. Fire onto those chaps. Some more volleys would be most useful. Because I'm going to smash him with cavalry. Charging my cavalry straight on. Okay, but I have my weakened unit of lancers chase down this unit of grenadiers. I'll actually first run these guys out and set up stakes. Lancegars chase down expatriate infantry. That's more important to destroy than militia. Just militia. I'm not gonna expose my cavalry to destroy militia. Maybe I might put my sharpshooters inside this building, inside the command HQ, rather than in here, because they might get stormed if they're in here. No. Oh, they hit the command HQ. Did I hit the command HQ? I hit the command HQ. Tell them to keep dropping the shots there. Keep blasting that area with shrapnel shot, because here become the infantry. focus fire all my batteries on that central gap. They're not interested in the breach. Halt. I'm not going to listen to them shout, make ready and fire. This unit, fire quick climb onto that unit of line. There we go. Oh, there we go. Come on in. Well, maybe not. Relocating in any instance. God. Didn't even see that. Stupid militia. That's what quick claim does. All those bodies. I don't always complain, I've not even got much on. Just a sec, guys, I'm gonna try something. And I'm back, but it doesn't seem to have helped. Oh no. Feels a lot quicker, actually. Smash into that line infantry if they're completely isolated, then probably come round and try take on their artillery. Come on, let's get these guys hidden. If possible. Oh. Bit of lag. I think it's whenever they try to charge the wall, the game just really hates it. Alright, let's pull back. Let's pull back this infantry unit from the wall. If that's what's screwing them up, trying to compute that mess, then I'll just pull them back. Expose my dragoons so we can get some shots off onto this regiment of horse, then I'm going to smash into them. Straight into the next regiment of horse, no time to wait. Once someone's finally come through the breach, not for long. Get one back, get two back. They are going to try to slow you down, but just keep clicking and you'll run through it. If you make them rout, they'll leave instantly. Routing good. Wavering. There we go. On you come. And there's nothing they can do about it. Let's turn off fire at will for this. So 152 still. 51, 50. Sweet. Run them ragged. Blowing holes into their line with quicklime. Should turn these guys back on fire at will. Oh, charging back out into the firing lines of the infantry. Should be it, shouldn't it? Oh, let's just end it. Decisive victory. Excellent. Quite effective. So in these battles, I'm not really looking to destroy them. Like, utterly destroy them, I'm just looking to absolutely eviscerate their troops. So there you go, they've gone from 4,700 men down to 1,026. So this force is dead. The force that was in this port is dead. Well, not dead, just mauled. Naples demands peace. No. I'm the United States, and I have lots of money. So much money, 1.7 million. I don't have to make peace with anyone. Let's go check on what's going on in Cairo, because it's tempting to build a series of forts and hunker down on the Cairo. Oh, no, actually, I'm about to take Jerusalem. So you could do with Russia pushing in from the east. But that's not going to happen, is it? See, Persia. I've been fighting a lot around Persia recently. Am I still at war with Spain? I probably am. No, I think I am at peace. Because remember, we're not pushing up through Central America anymore.
There is a port in this region that has not yet.
Workers are on strike in Brandenburg, which is
select the type of port here.
Fair enough.
A port will help your population grow. A trade port will.
Yes. Raiding Prussian troops. So you go down here to try block them. You come up here to block them from the north. You are replenishing, but we'll move up to back up him. you'll move. No, you won't move. You're going to reinforce, then go here.
At the ready.
And you will move out ready to try to engage this raiding force. You are another army being recruited.
Sir. Yes.
By the left. March.
Join them.
Make ready. March.
Ready and waiting order. Ready for order. Yes, sir.
It's this infantry unit. Got fusiliers. Getting two marines. Don't get engineers, you've got marines and you've got some grenadiers, so you need just more regular line infantry to fill out your ranks. It's more than enough. Oh, I've maxed out my recruitment of light infantry. What the hell? Oh well. Radio, so in the UK.
Forward! March!
So let's take this navy.
Underway!
And let's promote one of these to an admiral.
Sir, your orders?
Get these guys into ship. Get these guys embarked, sorry. I don't want to engage. I think I embark them into Bonn to Berlin to try to get more support. This stack of Königsberg though does have a pretty good shot at actually engaging, but anyway, looking at the time, I think we're the end of this part, so thanks for watching guys, and I'll see you next time.